Hi everybody, this is Kisra. I was surfing the net recently and I stumbled across this debate on which one is better, Windows operating system or Mac. Well, I thought I would put in my two cents. Neither one actually is good, but they all have this, you know, mentality where they dub you as basically a dimwit, that you don't know what you're doing and we have to show you how to do things. So a couple of years ago, I decided to use Linux, and I've been pretty happy with it. It does exactly what Windows does, only you're more in control, you know, of your OS, and I'm going to show you how to install it and what it looks like out of the box and stuff like that. The thing with Windows, though, just for all of you to know, is they come up with a version, and they don't debug it by the time they come up with the next one. So, you know, you spend endless time and money on antivirus programs and upgrading your hardware and stuff like that, and it really puts a dent in your bank account, and I kind of got fed up. Mac also has the same thing. You have limited software and it costs a lot of money, so I found an alternative and I'm going to share it with you guys. Now, I will admit, I did go through Linux hell by trying to learn how to make the sound work and the media player and stuff, but it was worth it. It really was worth it. Because I'm actually going to show you how to install it on a junk computer, which is cool because it gave it life. Because before I had Windows XP, and it was kind of sluggish with all the antivirus programs and stuff, and then to upgrade it to Vista, it just basically didn't run. So now, I'm going to show you exactly how to install it out of the box, and well, let's go. This is my laptop, my IBM, that originally came with Windows, but I killed it and I installed Linux. And the flavor I chose was Fedora. There's many others you can choose from, but this is the one I liked the most. And the first thing you want to do, okay, that I'm going to show you, is you're going to download the OS, or the operating system of Fedora. It's quite simple, and by the way, just to explain to you, this can actually be put on a CD and run. When I mean run, meaning it can just use the CD-ROM to run, like to use it. So you don't have to worry about, you know, your computer, which probably has your life on it, most likely, and you have to worry that files will get deleted or your Windows will be corrupted or something, so you can totally run it and use it from the CD-ROM itself. So now, I'm just going to show you the site. It's called fedoraproject.org, and from there you can just download it for yourself, and now this is the website, and you just click on download, which is right here. Now this is what I was talking about earlier, when it says installable live media. You're going to take the OS, the operating system Fedora, and you're going to put it on a CD. You pop it in your CD-ROM drive in your computer, and you can boot it from your CD. Your CD. So then that way you don't touch your files that are on your computer. So for those of you who are not comfortable yet to take the leap the way I did, you can just use Fedora from your CD and then take it out and you're back to your old computer that you had, your Windows, and your files are there and nothing changed. So what you would do is just click on download. Now I'm not going to do that right now because I have it already on CD, and we're going to go to my older computer and I'm going to show you exactly how to install it. And now just to show you a little bit of Fedora, these are some of the programs that it has. Like, for example, to edit your photos. Now I do modeling, so I edit all my photos, for example, using GIMP. The software is called Graphical Image Manipulation Program, very similar to Photoshop. Now, people might argue that Photoshop has more features, but GIMP does the job for me, and as you can see, it has all the tools and stuff to crop images, and you know, you can play with it on your CD. Now, also, it also has the equivalent, if you go on Office right here, for example, openoffice.org, Calc is the equivalent to Excel. And it has pretty much the same look and feel as Excel. You have Writer for Word, and then you also have, in the Office section, Draw, which is similar to Microsoft Visio. And for sound and video, this is the Draw, which is similar to, like I said, Microsoft Visio. So you can, you know, play with it and see all its features. Now, for those, there's also sound and video. Kaden Live is something I use to edit my videos, personally. There are many different programs you can choose, but these are the ones that that I like. This is how it looks, the interface of it. So you can edit your videos and stuff like that. Right now I'm going to go to the other computer and I'm going to show you how to install Fedora Live on CD, and you'll just see how simple it is.
Go.
Okay. Oh, I have to sit on the floor. Wow. Look what I'm doing for all of you guys. Okay. As you see here, this is my really, really, really dinosaur computer that I'm going to use to show you how to install Fedora. And this here is the hard drive that it's going to go on. I just kind of plugged it outside here, just so you can see. And inside there's another hard drive, which is also a piece of crap, which has got bad sectors and everything. And here used to be a floppy, remember those? Little thin disc-like things that we used to use back in the Stone Ages. And here, this mighty 52X CD-ROM that's going to, be used to install the Fedora operating system. Now this here, just if you can put your eyes to the screen, is a software called Spinrite that you can download from grc.com. Very highly recommended. What it does, in layman's terms, is it can sometimes recover your hard drive. So if your hard drive starts going a bit wonky, then you can use Spinrite, and it can detect bad sectors. If it has bad sectors, obviously you have to check it, which is what I'm going to do with this piece of crap over here. And let me just show you a little bit. Here we go. This is just a display that shows you after Spinrite finishes scanning your hard drive, and it tells you if you have like defective, B for defective, U for unrecovered, and R at recovered. So as you can see, all these little squares, it just means that this hard drive is actually good, even though it's a piece of crap, but it's actually good. So we're going to proceed and install Fedora. And what I'm going to do, I'm going to press this CD and take out the Spinrite CD. And I'm going to take my CDs here. Oh, this is FC14. See, I put it on a few CDs because this doesn't have a DVD. So here's the first CD, disk number one. I'm going to put it in here. And let's see what happens. Well, it's booting. It's got life. Now we'll press escape and we'll terminate this. We can exit it like that. Escape to reboot. Okay. Now I think it's reading here from the CD-ROM and at the same time it's rebooting, so give it a few seconds. Okay, now that the computer is booted, I'm going to choose install a new system, which is going to wipe out everything on this hard drive, and it's going to go fresh installation. Now we'll see what happens. This kind of looks like the Knight Rider, the kit, the car. You know, his name was Kit. In the front, he had this kind of flashing thing going. Kind of resembles that here. As you can see here, it's asking me for disk number 2. This computer doesn't have a DVD, so that's why I have to do it on multiple CDs. You won't have to go through that. You're going to have it on installable live on one DVD. So I'm going to take the second CD. As I'm popping in CDs here and doing this installation, I wanted to show you this Linksys wireless router. It's by Cisco. It's the E1000 here. And if I flip it here, you can see there's different types, E1000, which is what's in here, E2000 and E3000. Now, the one thing I noticed about it is that it comes with a CD-ROM, you know, to install it and everything, which is fine for some people, you know, but, you know, for people who are not familiar or not technical. But, you know, there are those of us who want to do things manually, you know, and I think that, you know, Cisco should give us that option, or actually any manufacturer should give us that option, you know, instead of putting, you know, your whole trust and your computer and everything into the manufacturer, and you don't know what the CD is installing for you or doing for you. It can open up ports that it assumes you need, but you don't. And I think, and we should have that option, you know. Cisco, if you're watching, maybe you should put the option in for those of us who want to do things manually. And also put your CD-ROM in there for people who don't know. But, you know, this is Microsoft mentality as far as I see, because it's doing things that you may not want it to do. And some of us who like to customize it, like me, you know, by doing it manually, you know, our computers are done in a certain way, and, you know, if something messes up or whatever, then we have to go back and rechange it and causes a lot of headaches. So I just thought I would share that with you. Oh, hi. This is 7-Up, not vodka. If you don't believe me, here's the can right here. It's actually empty. But see, 7-Up. Although, I gotta tell you, vodka would be pretty good right about now. That is good 7-Up. Now, I just want to say that Windows computers make great artifacts, and Mac computers make nice decor. Now, I'm sure there are a lot of Linux jokes out there, so the one thing I say is don't fear the penguin. This is probably spiked. It's got to be spiked, this 7-Up. But since we're talking about 7-Up, maybe we should do a little promotion. Make 7-Up yours. Guys, remember the commercial, 7-Up yours? Well, to all the Windows and Mac people, please don't diss my video. I'm just doing this because, like, I'm a Linux lover and I really like it, but I'm sure Windows is great and Mac is, you know, there's great graphics and stuff like that. But, you know, don't, try not to, you know, be too upset over this. And the reason I'm hyped on 7-Up, so you'll have to excuse me. One of the reasons actually that I did this video, I came across this really amazing commercial and I thought I should share this with you, and this is actually one of the main reasons why I chose to record this. So let me go now and show you exactly what this commercial is. So there you have it, guys. That's what Mac thinks of Windows. When I think of Mac, I think of a Big Mac. It gets me pretty hungry. Why? Well, I don't have the kablingy to go buy all the accessories that come with Mac. So I go for the free stuff, like Linux. Linux is free. Well, there you have it, guys. Linux is now installed. And now it's going to tell you to reboot. So that's what I'm going to do. Okay, here is Linux installed. I'm going to show you a few things that will work right away, such as the scanner. And I'm going to show you the spots right here. This is what I'm going to scan. And you will just get an idea of just how it works. Now, I'm not going to let the whole thing scan right away, but I'm going to hit cancel. But you can get, you have the idea of how it works. So, I'm going to stop that. Now, next thing I'd like to show you is the USB, which you can copy and transfer files. Put it in right here. And I'm gonna just drag two files or songs to the desktop here, and I'm gonna show you a couple of things about them. The first thing is, if you just note these extensions, one is called MPEG-4, the other one is FLV. These are just some of the extensions that Linux won't play by default. You will have to go and get the plugins for them to work. And I'm going to show you the media player, okay, that plays them. But by default, the extensions that the Linux will play would be OGG or OGG, and the other ones, like I said, you have to get the plugins from the net to play them. Now, it's up to you what kind of movie player you like, but the one I chose is called Totem. This is it here. Okay, it's called Totem Movie Player. Now, it doesn't have all the gimmicks like some others do, but if you like Windows style media or something, you can go with the other types that Linux has. And I'm just going to show you very briefly here. This is the MPEG-4 extension as it's playing, so you can see for yourself. This one here is the FLV one. So that's for the movie, the Totem and the media player. Another thing I can show you here is, like, you have OpenOffice.org Calc, which is the equivalent to Excel, the OpenOffice Writer, equivalent to Word, and you can play with it. There's many features. This is Evolution, this is the emails, this is the one that I chose. And as for this desktop here, this is called Gino. This is just the one that I chose purely for functionality and personal preference. There are some others, like KDE, that Linux has, and they're a bit more flashy, have a bit more gimmicks, but this is personal taste. So anyway, I hope that this helps, and if you have any questions, do feel free to message me. Regarding the plugins for MPEG-4 and FLV, if you want, message me, I'll steer you in the right direction. And anyway, don't be shy, so I hope this helps. Thank you.